Hi guys, this is Jason here from Nathaniel, and in this lesson, let's learn how to create a melody given an existing chord progression using the pentatonic scales which we have available. So the pentatonic scales in music are five notes, as the word penta seems to suggest. So we have two flavors. We have like a major pentatonic flavor and a minor pentatonic flavor. So if I'm in the key of B flat major, to build a pentatonic scale, it's nothing but the root, the second, the third, major third, five. That means you skip the four. So the pentatonic scale essentially will sort of hide away the notes which are considered as sort of tensions in a scale. So 1, 2, 3, 5, 6 octave to add to that. That means we ignore the 4 and the 7. So it'll be what was once. This is B flat major. Will now be. Those are the intervals as per the swaras. And you could also just sing it a couple of times. Na 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 da 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 da. It's a very pleasant scale. It's also what I call the anything goes scale. You know, you can use it pretty much over any chord progression, like how rock guitar players work. They will just shred on that pentatonic scale as though literally the sky is the limit, you know. So they just keep playing over that scale. And the B flat major pentatonic sounds great, but you could also create a minor version of that, which will be the G minor pentatonic. Okay, so to build a G minor pentatonic, what do? You start on G minor third. So this will work well on the G minor chord. So root minor third. Okay, perfect fourth, perfect fifth, minor seventh octave. Minor 7, perfect 5th, perfect 4th, minor 3rd, back to root. These are pretty much the notes of the B flat major chord. B flat major pentatonic scale, rather. So, but it's just a different flavor. So remember, we have two kinds of pentatonics: the major pentatonic, B flat major pentatonic, and the minor pentatonic, which is its relative minor, as we say, which is the G minor pentatonic. A quick trick to form the minor pentatonic given the major pentatonic would be to just move up a sixth. B flat C D E flat F G, that's the sixth. 1 6, 1 major sixth, and the major sixth will be the minor pentatonic equivalent. Fine. So what can we do with this pentatonic scale? Let's take the chord progression again. 6, 4, 1 B flat, 5 which is F. A very popular chord progression, as we already know, I'm sure. 1 and 5. So I have three kind of approaches to using the pentatonic scale while building melodies. The first one is just sort of maths. You just take patterns which you can form and just play those patterns. Start mechanically, and I feel it'll gradually grow organically into something with a lot more feel and creativity. So you can start with, what am I doing? I'm doing groups of threes. You could consider that. That's G, B flat, C, B flat, C, D, just in that pentatonic family. It works on pretty much on all the chords. You can even go descending thirds. E flat. some patterns. Okay, and if you add some rhythmic spice, so now I have this lick created. So you're just taking that same lick and starting it from different points. So if you take, you can do there, from the D, from C, from D, F, G, and it'll sound pretty much the same. So if you take any lick on the pentatonic with a few notes, you can actually transpose it by starting the lick. On different notes. And this can create a lot of patterns. Another way I like to use the minor pentatonic or the major or any pentatonic scale in general is to sing and play. Sing a phrase. Singing makes the whole process of composition of a melody very natural because you're singing without that filter of, you know, what do I do on the piano, can I do it and whatnot. You're singing. So yeah, try to learn a little bit of singing if you don't already, because we all have a free voice, free musical instrument right inside us. So take care of it and learn a good decent amount of singing if you can, if you get the chance. So sing a phrase and then try to play back that phrase on the piano, in which case it'll also train your ear. It'll also improve your listening and your conversion ability from mind to body, as we say. So if I do, see what happened there? It was a little tricky for me to play that melody. That's because I sang it. And by singing, I don't care about how easy or difficult it will be on the piano. I'm just singing freely. Because there's no filter while singing. So now I have to do the puzzle of figuring out what I just sang on the piano. Let's try one more. I quite like that. And it doesn't have to be exact. It just has to sort of match. And well, if you want it to be exact, then you have to work harder. I like that. And these melodies usually will continue for all the chords. See? Works, right? Quite a magical scale if you think about it. You just had to come up with one tiny tune and just works with all the four chords, right? So singing and playing can be really helpful. First sing, then play. Sing the next tune, play. And then try to record all these ideas maybe on a cell phone so that you can go back to it later. Maybe you can't get it immediately. So you take a break, maybe the next day or little later, you can try and match it on your respective instrument. Another thing you'd like to do with a minor pentatonic scale, as I already hinted at while singing and playing, is develop a very short phrase, what we call as a motif, okay? And repeat that phrase and bank on that phrase and make sure that phrase works well for all the four chords of this chord progression, and you've got yourself a pop tune. You've got yourself a very, very good selling tune, because if that tune can survive all these four chords, listeners are going to remember that tune, right? So if you take, something like that. Small variations can be done. Something like that, or combine it with singing, it'll really help. So first off, what have we done in this lesson? How do we form our scales, build the pentatonic, which is a subset of the seven. 5 out of 7, penta means 5. You have major penta and you have minor penta. Sort of like the anything goes scale. It works on anything. Form it, play it, jam over it over these four chords, which are very pop chords in this tutorial. And use patterns, mechanical patterns like groups of 3 to eventually become organic and make melodies that way. Use your voice, sing, and then play what you sing and push the limits. Push your technique. And also train your ear, because your piano has to latch on to what you're thinking and singing. And finally, build short motifs and short phrases and make it a point that that phrase or that motif which you made works for the entire set of four chords. And if it does, you've got yourself a very, very famous, about to be famous melody. Okay, so hope you guys found that lesson useful. Again, this is Jason here from the Nathaniel School of Music. Do consider subscribing to our channel if you haven't already. Share the music video, or share the video with all your music loving friends, and do consider supporting us on our channels like Patreon, and you'll get access to a lot more content coming your way. Cheers.